guys, it's Dad from Bags4Bubbles, and I'm back this week with a Rebecca Minkoff collection update. So these are my Rebecca Minkoff bags that I have currently after our big move, and I'll put previous collection videos down below. So this is what is left after the great reorganizing and downsizing of 2017, which I've talked about in other videos. And actually, I have quite a few Rebecca Minkoff things left. These are what I consider like classics from her, and these were kind of like the essential items that I wanted to have in my collection, and especially some of my favorites for traveling over here, which you guys have seen in a ton of Disney videos if you watch Bean Mommy with Style and that sort of thing. So I'm just going to take you through what's left, and like I said in my previous video, I am thinking about getting one more Rebecca Minkoff bag for my upcoming trips. They're just great durable bags to travel with, and I thought it'd be a special item to get for the conference. So first of all, I have these cute little pouches. I loved these pouches when they first came out, and these are not exactly available. They have like updated versions, but these are really, I guess you could call them vintage at this point. And I really like what I have because it's three separate types of hardware. There's different renditions of these. And this one has the gunmetal hardware, which I really like. And this actually matches this bag. Another thing that Rebecca Minkoff has had over the time is attention to detail. So a lot of these have fun linings and just little details on them that are really neat. So this Can't Buy Me Love little pouch matches this pink morning after clutch over here. And this is the regular size clutch. And I loved this set because it's the bright, vibrant pink. The leather is really super soft, and it's been super durable. So I've had these for a number of years, and that's a really cute set. And I love traveling with those too. And then I also have this splurge one, which I loved because of the stain and also the pretty purple. This one has the gold hardware on it, and the zipper is a little bit different. So you can see, like, it's got the articulated zipper that she had for a bit. This one has just the plain black lining, and this one has no articulation. So there's different series of zippers, and this one was one of the newer ones of these pouches, and it has the articulation. So this one's in really good condition, and it has Rebecca Minkoff there on the back. Then this other one is mine. It's also got the black lining and the zipper. This is a little bit older zipper. It does not articulate. These are really quality zippers. I mean, they slide really easily, and they are obviously, they've held up over time because I still have these. And I would just use these for like little grab and go things down inside my bags, or you can use them as a mini wallet in these morning after clutches. So probably the morning after clutch is my favorite style. This is the morning after mini, so this is the smaller one. And I love these because they are really versatile. You can unclip these and you can use them as a clutch with no strap, for one. You can use it as a long crossbody, how I have all these set up right now. Or you can also take these, the chains through, and it's a little bit hard to do one-handed, but you can also take these through and actually double it up and make it a shoulder bag. So I love how versatile these are. I use these on trips a ton, and I really like this size. This holds all of the essentials, but when I'm filming, a lot of times on travel trips I am filming and I have to have all my camera supplies, I have to go up to this size, which is the regular size. I've also had the Mac Daddy, and it is huge. You can fit like an iPad in there, so it is really, really huge and a really ample size if you need like your Kindle or your iPad with you. But this is the regular size, and it's been taken on a ton of trips. You can tell it has some jean transfer and that sort of thing from being used a ton. And down on the bottom of the regular size, it's got the studs, and this size has the small studs as well. The difference is there's 5 on this one and 4 on the smaller one, on the mini. So I also have this size, this regular size morning after clutch in gray, and this is a really durable, like almost elephant skin gray, and it also has the pocket here in the front. The lining on this is a like leopard cheetah print type of print, and so it's really fun as well. And I've used this one a ton. It has like a muted silver hardware, like an antique silver, and this one has the gunmetal hardware. So I like the hardware in both of those. And those have serviced me on a lot of trips, especially the gray is really great. And the same thing with these. Actually, I have this set up already to be a shoulder bag. You can see how I have it set up where you just double the chain over, and then it just easily gets tossed on your shoulder, and you can easily change it to crossbody while you're out and on the go. So I love that. So how I set these up is I put all of my camera supplies, wallet, and things like that down in here. In this front area, where you can leave it unclipped or you can clip it. I just put like lip gloss, maybe makeup, sometimes my phone, and those sorts of things down at the front, and that's really super handy. And so you can see this one's the same way. And this one has a really fun lining as well. So then the last larger bag that I have, because I have downsized the size of bag that I use in addition to not having so many bags in my collection, but this is the Morning After Mini, the MAM. And so this is the satchel style. For a long time in my bag collecting, I have been very partial to the satchel style. And so the style has always worked really well for me. I like how it has the two handles that you can carry it like this, and then also the longer strap that you can put on your shoulder or wear cross body. Again, just like the clutches, this has the little pocket in front that you can put your easy grab and go items, and then a big space down here in the middle, and then this is the dust bag that goes with it. And I ended up deciding to keep this one. So the story behind this is really unique because it has rose gold hardware. These were really like limited run a number of years ago. And I also had the new NYC edition with the rose gold hardware. It was a beautiful black bag, really nice thick leather. But I never used it because the leather was so thick and it was in pristine, perfect condition. I really honestly didn't use it because I was afraid of messing it up. So the really thick black leather one has gone on to another home, but this one, I couldn't part with it because it was like this plum color, such a unique color, really great for fall, and I just felt inclined, if I was gonna, you know, go through my collection and make myself keep one or the other, this is the one that I ended up keeping. So really, either one could have worked because obviously that black leather one could have gone with anything. Really gorgeous bag, honestly, but this is the one that I ended up keeping. And so what I'm looking at now is she's come up with a number of new styles, one called the Love. There's a lot of cute crossbody bags. So that's what I'm looking at for my trip upcoming. But you can tell I've had all of these items, bags and accessories, for a number of years, probably some of them pushing 10 years at this point. And they're still in service in my bag collection. Like, absolutely no complaints. The zipper's all really great quality. I can zip them a lot easier with two hands so I can hold the bag. You can see this is one of those articulated zippers. So it's a little bit easier to zip these with one hand if the strap's not in the way. Anyhow, the zippers are really nice, good quality when I can zip them with two hands. I'm just doing a quick video today, so I didn't set up my tripod, but you can see they zip really nicely. Really nice thick zippers, and they've really held up well for how much I've used them. So that's where I'm at, Rebecca Minkoff collection. Let me know what you guys have in your Rebecca Minkoff collection down below. And also you can check out the links that I have from older videos showing my collection and different comparisons to see how it's changed over time. And these are the ones that have stood the test of time. These are my favorites, you could say. So that's it for today. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.